Wow. Wow. So, you can see, you can only read. Wow. I'm speechless. For the first time ever. No, seriously, I had to prepare some notes too because I only get to do this twice and it has to be perfect.
My daughter.
My son. Perfect.
John.
My daughter-in-law. Perfect. As all your kids are. They're perfect too. In all seriousness, Nancy and I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you all here to celebrate with us the marriage of our son, Ty. Our beautiful new daughter-in-law, Jennifer. What a couple. Yeah. And even though the Leafs are playing the Canadiens in Toronto tonight. You know what? We have the hottest ticket in town here in Orangeville at Hockey Valley. Anyone else? All the people that we wanted to be here are right here with us. Thank you all for coming. David and Elaine, we want to personally thank you both for hosting this beautiful, magnificent wedding here today for all our friends, family, and guests. You guys have been great. We've got to spend some time this year. Think the world of both you and your family. Thank you. Jennifer, you look stunning. I'm so excited to officially welcome you into our family. But you know what? We've considered you a part of our family for quite some time. We hope we've shown that to you. Thank you. Ty's never been happier. And Nancy, I want to commend you for all the fantastic, look at these decorations. This whole venue is just above and beyond. Outstanding. Great job, both of you. Ty. My Ty. Not the drink, you know, I haven't had a drink. I might need a drink. Big day for you. Big day for all of us. But you know what? I've been to many, many weddings where the father of the groom gets up and talks for 20 minutes, brags like every proud father should, how great their son was, and on, how they're the best, and relives their entire childhood. But you know what? I could do that, but, and I had a lot of nice things to say about you, but I can't, because you have me on a time limit. So I had all these really nice, cool things to say about my son, and I had to cut them all from my speech in lieu of time. Sorry, I apologize. Moving on. However, Nancy says, I must be serious. Hold on. See you. Kleenex moment. For my wife, not me. Ty. I've had a long time to prepare for this night. And your mother and I would like to say thank you for being a wonderful son. Thank you for being a beautiful brother for your sister Taylor. We're so proud of you and what you've accomplished. This is your first of, you've given us many proud moments, but none more proud than what you've given us all tonight. And this is your first of many big moments with Jennifer. And I think you all would agree, this is a big moment. Your mother and I have watched your relationship blossom, and you two are absolutely made for each other. But I too have been blessed to have this wonderful woman to my right here for almost 29 years. She's been incredible. In actual fact, she deserves most of the credit for this guy. She did all the hard stuff. I got to do the easy stuff, the fun stuff, take him to hockey, do this, or she did the changing of the diapers and all that stuff. I had no interest in that. So I want to commend your mother because she is awesome. Yes, she is.
And so! Wait, no.
But you know what? So being able to raise two kids like Ty and Taylor, that's a walk in the park for David and Elaine. And I got to tell you a little story. When I met them for the first time and heard that Elaine had 4 children at the same time. And I paused and I said, wow. And then I started thinking, is that even possible? And then when I got to meet the two of them for the first time, I went home and I said, I just met real life Superman and Wonder Woman. Congratulations to you both for the outstanding job for your 4 kids. Andrew, I apologize. Andrew's a big brother, so bad. Apologize. Now, Ty, sometimes you've known your dad to go a little over the top. And I said to myself, this is the biggest day of your life, so what would be a day like this without going a little over the top for you and Jennifer? So that being said, DJ Mike, can we get you up here for a second? We have a little prayer or something. Here he comes. DJ Mike, everybody. Okay, pause. Everybody ready? Truth be told, there's more to this real love story than you all are even aware of. It's about a small town girl living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train from Orangeville. She met a city boy. Ty was raised in Cambridge and Georgetown. And as you all know, this story goes on and on and on. Ty and Jeff, don't stop believing. And hold on to that feeling the first time you met. With that in mind, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take you all on a little journey with Ty and Jeff.
Ha ha ha! blast, the home team fills behind.
Hey guys, here's Clark Gardens from King City today with our favorite former league captain of all time, Wendel Cla. Good day out in North Hockley Valley, and it's fun to know your mother, your sister Taylor, and I are here. It's going to be a great day today. I know you're a real generous big league fan, and look for important was going to eat something memorable. So we got the man here himself, Mr. Wendel Cla. Well, you need some best wishes and a bowl of the toast of the night crew. Wendel?
Thank you. And time, Jen. Sorry I can't be there, but we're going to give you a jersey here on behalf of myself. And hopefully you guys can enjoy it and hang it in the right spot. It's okay, Jen. You don't have to hang it under your bed. But remember, Tom, sometimes you got to be a pylon for this to work out. But hope you guys have a great day, and let's have a great toast to the new couple. Thank you.
Classic jersey, and he actually had a commemorative patch stating, "Congratulations, Ty and Jen, March 22nd, 2014.
Got a tiny one and a bigger one.
Anyways, moving on. This has been a great day. Cheers, Ty, all the best for a long, happy life together. Here's a toast to Ty and Jim.